We have been working with collaborative groups for 15 years. And the data conversations just emerged out of realizing that groups needed a way to focus their talk and also focus their efforts so that it didn't all just stay as talk in the meeting room. So we have an earlier book called Data-Driven Dialogue. And so Got Data was essentially what we learned between those volumes, because we realized the subtitle, Got Data, Now What, was really the issue. When we started with the first book and the earlier work, people didn't have enough data. So we would work on collaborative process, and they'd say, where's the data? Now, over probably the last half dozen years, it's reversed. So now we have groups that are just swimming in data, but don't have the collaborative toolkit to winnow that, make use of it, and take action. People think because they have data, whether it's at the state level or national level or some kind of benchmark, that they can just throw it on the table and somehow make meaning of that. There's two things that the learning cycle, our model, does. One, the conversation starts without the data, which we've discovered is just hyper-powerful, because the first stage is asking people to predict and make assumptions about what they're going to see. It's the assumptions that's the conversation that's gold. Now, the other thing we've seen with that's helping groups become much more successful is closer to practice data. So shorter cycles with formative assessment, shorter cycle with teacher-made assessments, with end-of-unit kind of things, things that are under teachers' control because they can't push it off. If it's the state test, it's like it's such a gap between the teaching and the testing and the connections and the alignment that people tend not to take that real seriously, even in high accountable systems. Or worst, in a high accountable system, they try to just go after the low-hanging fruit and move it, as opposed to let's look deeply at this state of kids' learning. The other thing we've discovered is, and it's another in the development of groups, there's kind of a evolution. Initially, people will look at some kind of a formative assessment and go, oh, there's some gaps here. What do we need to do for these kids? They look forward. What tends not to happen without consciousness and leadership is to say, huh, there's a gap here. What's going on in core instruction that's producing that gap? And without that kind of leadership, that second conversation never happens. We're really trying to build a collaborative learning model that has a way of talking inside it. And our experience is that healthy teams have cycles of learning, just like there's cycles of learning in the classroom. So this is a way of talking about practice that really is looking at the influence of their actions on kids.